I woke up one day and I saw nothing.
Oh my gosh.
Everything was black. I lost my sight. I couldn't see.
Dude, that's so scary. What did you do?
The stress made me blind. Louder, screaming louder, my superpower. Gonna
take you higher. Do-do-do-do.
Alyssa, you're stressing me out today. You guys, her hair, she put some color shampoo conditioner on it, so it made it very yellowy orange. We might work with it. My goal is to take her coral, but if coral goes over yellow, it's just gonna turn, it's not gonna look like this.
I was unfaithful.
You were unfaithful.
Forgive me.
Get back up, girl. You let me do what I need to do.
Yes, please fix me.
On the phone, you said that you want this huge transformation. You want coral and pinks, but if it doesn't come out, I have to do what I gotta do. Come on, let's go. Come on. All right, time to put your superhero cape on. So I got a little surprise for you. Are you ready to see it?
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
It's you on the cover.
That's amazing.
This is from Dubai.
It's my face.
It's your face.
My face.
It's pretty light. She's natural dark blonde. So we're gonna use Magnum 8. Always wear protection. I'm gonna go in like I would a normal routage retouch and then apply it off the scalp. My goal is to try to lift up her natural and remove some of her yellow that we have going on here. You guys, I think we're in luck. So you can see how quickly Alyssa's hair has turned blonde. You can see here, it kind of turned slightly peachy. That tells me that she's able to go coral. We can work with a little pink salmon tone. I'm gonna grab the Magnum 8 that I have here in my bowl, but this time I'm gonna dilute it some because I am overlapping a little bit, and I want to acidify the lightener by adding a little bit more developer and also adding Olaplex. So I'm gonna drag the lightener down here. I'm just gonna overlap. I find that incubation really helps the lightener, even with the lower developer, pull out the color. Okay, so we are 15 minutes in. As you can see, her hair has lifted significantly. So now we're going in with 10 volume Magnum 8 straight on her routage. And then after this, we let her process for additional 15 to 30 minutes, depending on how quick she lifts. All right, so we are 15 minutes in. When I peel it, I can see this is as light as she's gonna get through here. I'm even happy she got this far. What I'm gonna do though is pre-tone her with our Express Toner Blush just to kind of mute it and soften it and give it a natural base. The hard part is done. It's always the lightening, lifting, bleaching process that takes forever. So now the fun part begins, is adding the color in. I love to pre-tone. It gives me something to work with. I am not gonna push her hair any further. I am praying that the Express Toner Blush will give me enough coverage that it's gonna look good enough for me to do the overlay of superpowers on. So let's go ahead and apply the blush throughout. You know what? We need to move quickly. So I'm just gonna pour it on through here and just massage it in. So when you take a look here, you can see the blush tone taking place at the routage. That gives me something to work off of. All right, so we are 5 minutes in so far. Take a look here. You can see that the blush Express Toner really took at the routage. Just know that it's gonna appear lighter when it's dry. This is where pre-toning is so important. You guys, check out that routage color. This would be ideal. Take a look at her sides here. When you look at her sides, it's pretty yellow, right? Now I'm gonna turn towards the Guy Tang My Dandy Swatch Book, Underlying Pigments Watch in the back of the page. So I thought her hair was a level 9, but there's a lot of level 8 pieces. The Express Toner sits at a 9. That's why you're seeing minimal deposit here and maximum deposit on the level 10. I'm gonna have to do a full concentration of the pastel coral, but first we need a trim because her hair has gone through a lot of overlapping. All right guys, so I wanna create a shadow root. So even though we pre-tone her, I wanna mute it down so it doesn't look so vibrant in there. I'm gonna pull out Purple Raven, superpower, and then I'm gonna pull out Green Aurora. This is gonna create like a charcoalized tone and neutralize each other. And look at that tone. That's so pretty, right? We are gonna do Cosmic Coral. She has a lot of level 8 parts. I'm gonna have to make it slightly more pigmented. I'm gonna do two different formulations of Cosmic Coral. One, I'm gonna add Crimson Spell to it. And the next one, I'm gonna add Pink Possession. Possession, which is our new direct dye superpower shade. All right, so I mixed up a concoction here. They are a little bit darker than expected, but the reason why I do that is because I want more coverage. It looks very identical, but one has less pigment than the other. When it mixes with the gold in her hair, it's gonna look more coral. The way we color the hair underneath is gonna be slightly different than the way we color the hair on the top. Pivot that horseshoe shape into a point. So the section underneath, I'm gonna do your traditional color melt, going from the darkest color into the lightest color. The top, I'm gonna over-direct everything towards the face and do almost like a halo effect. And we're gonna outline to define by putting the dark color on. As you can see here, I'm dragging the color down to the mids, but leaving the ends out. But instead of just placing my second formula just on the mids like this, I place the second formula on top of that base color at the Routage and melt it in so it looks seamless. Now you're creating another color. I think that's really, really cool. So now that we had ombre'd the first two formulas, I'm gonna go in with my third formula here and go ahead and blur it in. Now this one is a lot more sheer. I'm gonna blur it down. Look how pretty that looks. You can see the coral taking place. The Superpower Direct Dye spreads very, very easily because the consistency is so smooth. It allows you to just spread the product. So now let's take all the clips down. Now we're gonna work the top. So this is very important, body positioning. So now I'm gonna outline to define the top section, doing the exact same thing. But this time, we're over-directing everything to the front. Okay, so from this point on, I'm gonna drop her down low. So having a little bit of storm cloud ensures that it looks nice, smoky, and soft. Okay, so now I'm gonna get in between. I'm gonna step over her. And this is really important, step over her. I'm gonna step over you, Alyssa. And I'm just gonna get a mesh sheet. It's gonna protect her forehead. All right, so now I'm gonna over-direct everything towards the front. You can see I put the first formula right on the Routage. Start with your second formula from this point. So this formula right now is the formula I use on her ends. I'm gonna sandwich it right in the center. The lighter color is in the center, and the two darker color is sandwiching the middle color. So every time I move back, all of this has to travel all the way to the front. So when it drops and swoops back, you can see the angling of the color. I have to admit to you about something. Okay, so you know how I got you in at 7 a.m. this morning? I slept at 3 a.m. last night. I didn't get much sleep, but I know you drove out here at 3 a.m. I've been working a lot. I work like almost every day. Probably, no, actually, I work every day. I'm online talking to hair besties, communicating with them with formulas. I have a color line that I'm running. I travel almost every week to a different country to do shows. My friends tell me to take a break, but I can't stop. Like, I feel like if I don't work, I'm wasting time. 4 years ago, it took a toll on me. I was so stressed out by social media that I literally hurt myself. I woke up one day and I saw nothing.
Oh my gosh.
Everything was black. I lost my sight. I couldn't see.
Dude, that's so scary. What did you do?
The stress made me blind. I lost my sight for like close to 4 hours. I don't think people realize how stress can be so dangerous. I am afraid that one day I will wake up and I won't be able to see again.
I've been there a little bit, and actually I work a lot too. I have, you know, a day job, and then I have another job where I do my performance stuff on the side. And
when we did your hair the Phoenix color, you show us some of your skills.
Yeah, even though I do hula hooping as a performance thing, I really started it as a thing for myself because I needed a movement art and to, you know, be like in my body.
And I think it tells a story when you do it, because when I saw you do it, I was like, how do you juggle all of the hoops?
Once you like know each trick so well, then you can start to string them together and then they become muscle memory. What starts happening is like this flow state. You're not thinking so much. That's the emphasis, is like living in the moment.
My recent escape is actually music. I'm learning how to play a piano.
Wow.
I'm taking vocal lessons and I'm making music now. So writing music has been my outlet to write and tell a story and have a message. When you're doing something for yourself, I always feel like I'm being selfish or something. I'm always worrying about other people and how other people feel, and I forget about my own feelings. But I think the worst kind of selfish is being selfish to yourself. I'm trying to figure that out right now. I really don't know how to balance my life.
I know you care so much, and like, we love that about you. I feel like when you're taking care of yourself, then you can like function on a better level so that you're feeling better to give like more to the world. I actually started seeing a therapist, and it's like really helps me a lot. I'm a person who's really critical of myself. I think for people who are like so passionate, it's really important to find a little bit of balance in your life.
Seeing that you seek help kind of inspires me and let me know that maybe it's something I might need for myself too. And I'm so glad you opened up to me. This makes me feel that much more relatable to you. Thank you. That's all I can say is, let's rinse out your color. You ready?
Yeah.
This is all of you, and all of me matters. I scream it louder, scream it louder. My superpower. Gonna take you higher.
Alyssa, I'm obsessed with your hair color. How do you feel about it?
Oh, I'm so excited for
this. You cannot move because you're in the perfect position to show off your color. My favorite is the coral bits, like through here and through there. Where we place that shine line in right through here, you can see it kind of just blend down. I also love the shadow root that we put in. It looks muted so you don't draw your attention right to the scalp.
It's so new and that makes it really exciting. I never really saw myself as a purple person.
From especially up here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Seeing it all come together.
It was a lot of work. You came in with paranormal hairtivity situation. You made my life very hard. I hang in there for you. Click thumbs up, guys. Subscribe, follow me on Instagram and everything. And download my new single, Superpower, on iTunes, Spotify. Love you much. Bye, guys.
Dragging you through the mud, what was I thinking? What was I thinking?
I'm sorry that I quit on us.
Sorry that I gave up on us.